Okay, folks, here we are at the South Island Superstock Championships for the 2016 season, and the defending champ is this man here, the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai. Now, Malcolm, a little bit different than last season, though. Obviously, a few extra cars have come down to join in the party.
Yeah, I see there's a couple of North Islanders slipped on down to try and put their hand on our cup, so, yeah, we'll have to see what happens later on.
Absolutely, and of course, you haven't really done a lot of Superstock racing around the countryside this year, so do you reckon you got the what it takes to maybe do a back-to-backer?
I'll give it a go, but if I'm getting nowhere, our wee visitors won't be taking much home with them. So, hey, we'll hang around and go hard to the last heat. And if we're not going any good, well, unfortunately, we'll have to hit the brakes and have a bit of a play.
Now, traditionally, the Nelson guys and you guys have a very sort of different sort of relationship. So, is that of any major concern to you tonight?
No, not at all. Come here expecting a war with Nelson. So, hey, as soon as they start, I'm all fair games. I've told my boys once they start. Fucking I'm in, so yeah, I'm just not scared at all, and it's been a while since I've been up here, so I might need to, if I don't get my bones rattled, I might have to rattle a few bones.
Absolutely, how the car, I mean, I'd see you did some other event there about a month or so ago. What was that all about?
Yeah, no, it was the Leadfoot Festival up at Rod Millen's farm. I was lucky to be invited, never had a Superstock up there before, and yeah, we did pretty good times. It wasn't nothing like Rod in the 50s, but we weren't the slowest, we were in the middle somewhere, but just everyone was surprised how fast the stock cars really are.
Was it on road tyres, or did you have the hoosiers?
I run hoosiers for two heats, and then I put some road tyres on, but they both work the same because we run soft springs and lock diffs. Yeah, had all the traction in the world. I actually broke the diff in it a couple of times, the fifth arm, so plenty of traction.
So safe to say the car's going okay then?
Your car's going real good. We run the engine in going up the hill, so we run it home last weekend, and yeah, it's going really good.
Okay, well, a good sponsor on the car too, Malcolm, who are they?
Oh, of course, Suck It Up, Hydro Excavation Specialists, and CHS, Total Oils, Graham Morrison Motors, Murray Gorge. We've got a few on there. We better have a look. Brownlee's Contractors, Elite Wheels, Auto Scan Solutions, and Safer Toolboxes, which is a New Zealand-made toolbox. We don't get many of them anymore. And the Kaikanui Tavern in Kaipui, they're new on board this year in the Bottle-O, so we could be doing big things with the Bottle-O next year. We're just working on a deal now.
And we've got Fletch. And, of course, Fletch has been up and down the countryside having a bit of a race. And Jace, mate, come with a bit of game plan here at Nelson Speedway.
Drive around, stay straight, try not to get hit.
Okay, so, people like yourself, to determine the outcome of a South Island title. I assume if you're not going to do that well, you're certainly going to be helping the guys that potentially from your club that where you can.
Okay, given that it's unlikely my competitors are going to see this until well after the fact, yeah, the plan is basically first couple of races, if we're in the top 10 and we're looking, that's our goal, we'll keep it clean, but come the third race, if we're not in that top 10, I'll be looking to help out the Christchurch boys for sure.
Now, you've done a few laps around the tracks over the last couple of months. The car's been performing okay. You said earlier on, maybe a bit of an overheating issue.
Yeah, we've just got nothing that's really a great concern, but she's just coming in a bit hotter than it used to when we at the beginning of the season. So it's just something we're having to monitor and in the meantime try and identify exactly where it's going wrong. But yeah, the car's still performing well. She's still running hot on the track, so to speak, but she's coming off the track pretty hot as well.
Good sponsor on the side of the car, who are they?
So the sponsors of my car, we've got, excuse him, he's a bit of a noisy bugger. We've got R&G Homes, our primary sponsor, along with Ham the Holiday Homes.
Okay, folks, here we are, 2016 South Island Superstock title at Nelson Speedway. We've got a chance to catch up with the 3NZ of Graham Barr. Now, Graham, mate, come a long way to do the South Island title. Any reason that's become an event for you?
Yeah, well, hey, at the end of the day, I've never done it in my racing career, so I thought, well, it was an opportune time. I've only got one more year to run on my Superstock career, so yeah, it's another one to tick off the box, isn't it?
Okay, so obviously you're not looking to go too much past this season when it comes to Superstock, mate. Well, you've got to come back and have a crack at 1NZ anyway, don't you?
Yeah, well, I'm saying Palmerston will be my last year. Next year I'll do the New Zealand's, and then yeah, the car will go on the market, and I'll be out.
I mean, you've probably pretty much hit a bit of a peak in your career as well. I mean, a couple of times 3NZs, saved a lot on signwriting bills this season, that's for sure.
Yeah, well, anyone that knows me, I'm a bit of a miserable bugger, so yeah, that's paid dividends, isn't it?
Okay, bit of a game plan. Come down here, don't know what to expect, obviously. Raced with some of these guys before, but have you got a game plan?
No, all I can reflect back on is the New Zealand's here, and it wasn't that good, actually. I didn't qualify, and yeah, I really struggled with the track. So we're sort of, a bit of a lurgy, so I want to get that out of the road as well.
I suppose they having raced the New Zealand title here, you sort of know what the track might do, so therefore set the car up accordingly for that.
Yeah, I looked back in my book and looked at the records that I had, and at the end of that New Zealand chance meeting, you know, the car was going quite well, so that's what I've dialed in tonight, so we'll see how it goes.
Good stuff, mate. So it's good to see you here anyway, and of course you'll be registered as what Nelson car today, are we, tonight?
Well, no, with the 3NZ, well, I don't have to have a Nelson in on me, but no, it's just good to come down and support the Nelson boys. They're always up home and campaigning in the North Island, so no, it's just nice to repay the favour.
And I'm sure they appreciate it too. A good sponsor on your car, who are they?
Hilltop Contracting is another good mate of mine, Blastways, yeah, Sign Fusion, all the good boys.
Car of Malcolm Nartey. Of grid number four, it is the 99 car of Trevor Lynham. Oh, sorry, the 99C car of Dennis Andressi, and that will be a very familiar name for all you Superstock lovers. Of grid number five, it's the 46 tank of Blair Cunningham. Of grid number six, it's the fourth of the North Islanders, it's Jake Baker. Of grid number seven, it's the 95 car of Alex Hill. Of grid number 8, it is the 186 car of Jared Gray. Of grid number 9, it is the 99N car of Trevor Lynham. Of grid number 10, it is the 9 car from Christchurch of Jamie Hamilton. Of grid number 11, it is the 29C car of Murray Gregg. Of grid number 12, it is the 6 car of Ben Taylor. Of grid 13, is the 56 car of Kerry Pajerski. Of grid number 14, it is the 8 car of Damien Alley from Christchurch. Of grid number 15, it is the 84 car from Nelson of Anthony McKenzie. Of grid 16, it is the 5 car of Jason Fletcher. Of grid number 17, it is the 27 car of Peter Fields. Of grid number 18, it is the 3NZ man from Palmerston North, the ex-North Island champ, the three-time 3NZ champion of Superstocks. It is Graham Barr in the High Wing Warrior 3NZ car. Of grid number 19, it is the 7 car of Neil Frew. Of grid number 20, it is the 48N car of Brett Nichols. 21, the 23 car of Jacob Brownlee. 22 is the 10 car of Alex Bright. 23 is the 93 of Sonny Hammond. Of grid number 24, it is the 1NZ. He was 5 from 5 here last time. What can he do? Can he make it 6 from 6? He starts off grid number 24. That is the 1NZ of Shane Harwood. Of grid number 25, it is the 34 car, and that's Rebecca Barr. Of grid 26, it's the 4 car of Kevin Clive. And of grid 27, it is the 92 car of Jason McConnell. A 27 car field. This should be an absolute beauty here at the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstock Championships here at Frosty's Towing Nelson Speedway here. The clerk on the course says we are ready. The Fuchs Lubricant South Island Superstock Champs is underway. And as they enter shop corner now, it is the 19 car of Malcolm Nartey around the outside to the man from Woodford Glen Speedway. Leads it now, followed by the 74 of Ian Clayworth and the 46 of Blair Cunningham here. A bit argy-bargy to start it off there. Nelson there, a 2, 3 and 4 with Alex Hill there moving into fourth position now. And grid number 5, it looks like it's the 36 car of Jack Baker there. But the 9 car spits down into 5 as the 99N car of Trevor Lynham goes to the infield. The 36 of Baker hits the 9 of Hamilton. So Hamilton's getting a bit of ding early here for the Fuchs Lubricant South Island Superstock Championship here. Harwood's moved up to 10th from 24, so Shane Harwood trying to do 6 from 6 here at Frosty's towing Nelson Speedway. But it is the 19 car of Malcolm Nanatai who leads it now from the 46 of Blair Cunningham. Then we go back to the 74 car of Ian Claywood, then the 95 of Alex Hill, and then the 186 car of Jared Gray as he gives Alex Hill a bit of a bunger there. And Jacob Brownlee passes me in the control tower. Right front flat tyre there for Brownlee, so he's off now. One gone, 26 remaining here. 4 laps gone. About 11 to go now. Nartai, Ewing slowing down there. Maybe a bit of a mechanical problem, or maybe wants to hit the 19. It may possibly be a left rear flat tyre. I must be saying there, but Nartai still leads it from the 46 car of Cunningham. Then we go back to the 74 of Ian Claywith, and it looks like the 99 of Dennis Andresia now moves into fourth position now. There's a 48 of Nichols down the inside. We haven't seen him racing here for quite some time. It's Harwin now. He's moved into fifth position now. As way over, oh, rollover! Well, not quite a rollover. Looks like the 186 car of Jared Gray had a spin in the 48 car. I said he hasn't been here for a while. He won't want to remember that one because his entire left front wheel of Brett Nichols' car is gone. Look at the order now. Malcolm Nartai leads it. There's a bit of smoke coming there from Claywood, but it seems to always have smoke on it. That means it's fuming and ready to go for more. Bars moved up quite a bit here. The 3NZ car started off grid number 18. He looks to be in about 7th position. Of course, Harwood, 24. He's in 5th position. So Baker, the 36 car, started off grid number... Yep, 6 there, he's in 3rd position. There's a he's not happy with it, Brett Nichols, as you would imagine here, with the entire left front gone. Must be somewhere in the fence surely, or maybe on the ground already, but Nichols, he doesn't look happy. So 2 cars gone now. That is the 48 of Brett Nichols, as you can see, on corner 3, and the 23 car of Jacob Brownlee's. So we're down to 25 in this race. Produski's up there. Rebecca Barr's moved a fair bit up. So the North Islanders on the charge. Jamie Hamilton, he's lucky to be in 6th position there. It's worked a treat. And these drivers would have been ready here. 7 laps gone, 8 laps to go. So we're not even halfway through the first heat of this, the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstock Champs. And we have an early starter in the 36 car, but it's still go anyway. So the 36 of Jake Baker there gets an early start. But it is the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai who still leads it from the 46 of Blair Cunningham. Then it's the 36 car of Jake Baker there. He might have a problem here with a flat tyre. It might be the right rear because he's bouncing over it, but he's still got the pace on. Maybe something to do with the setup of the car. As we have a spin, there is the 5 car of Fletcher, the Hamner Holiday Home sponsored car of Jason Fletcher. In the second, we've got Blair Cunningham still trying to reduce the gap there between him and Nartai. Clayworth, Harwood's now into 4th position. A nice wee hit there from Jared Gray on the 34. So the man on woman there, and it looks like man wins that one, but the 34 of Rebecca Barr is still in front of the 186 as the 74 of Claywith goes in the infield now, spins out there. So action packed here in heat number one of the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstocks here. There's Malcolm Nartai there, one NZ. Shane Howard, Graham Barr now. He's moved up heaps now. He's in third position now. The three NZs on the charge. Shane Howard now in fourth position. Then we go back to Jamie Hamilton in five. There's a bit of a spin up there on three and four. And Gray's gone to the infield now. Fletcher still stood here. 12 laps gone, and it's Nartai, followed by Cunningham, Barr, Harwood, Hamilton, Andresian, Lyon, and Mackenzie Bright. As there's a bit of a tangle there, it's the 74 and the 27. Oh no, it looks like the 9 car smoking up there. He started his own little fire on the infield now. Looks to be really hot now. Might want to get the fire extinguishers on it here. But Nartai now, he still leads it. As he comes past me on the control tower, white flag now. Then we go back to the 46 of Cunningham. Then the 3 NZ of Barr. Then the 36 of Baker. Then the 1 NZ of Shane Harwood. That's the top five at the moment. Heaps of cars slowing down, dropping off, but it will be the chequered flag for the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai. Then we go back to the 46 of Blair Cunningham. The 3 NZ of Graham Barr. The 36 of Jake Baker. And then the 1 NZ of Shane Harwood. That is your top five. Mackenzie in 6th, Bright 7th, Lyon 8th, Taylor 9th, and McConnell in 10th.
The 19 car of Malcolm Nartai. First blood goes out to him. Malcolm, track looking pretty good. You not looking so good.
Oh yeah, Heineken Fitness, mate. Yeah.
It comes in handy sometimes, but not when you want to get out there in this, obviously there's pretty hot temperatures out there. And for those people that don't know, I mean, obviously you've got a bit of a sweat going on, a bit red on the face there, but obviously clearly it's pretty hot in there. Why is that?
Well, we're sitting right on the engine and above the gearbox, and we sat on a red light then for 5 to 10 minutes, and all the heat just come up through the car, and it was pretty hot in there, so yeah, I was glad to get out of there and have a bit of ice. So.
Now, you're pretty lucky with that first one there. Obviously, you spotted a gap, went through it, and the guys sort of, they left you alone because they couldn't catch you. Bit of hard work coming up in the next two heats, though.
Yeah, starting mid to near pack for the next two, so that'll be more fun trying to get through them. Yeah, I'd say there'll be a bit more carnage in the next two.
Track conditions out there?
Perfect. Brendan Higgins said they'd be good, and they were, so well done, Brendan.
And car, how's that going?
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Driver, how's he going?
Terrible.
Best of luck for the other two.
Cheers, Jace.
One NZ man himself, it is of course Shane Harwood. First and foremost, Shane, on behalf of the pits, media and stuff, thanks very much for organising all these sizzlers for us, mate. It's much appreciated. Just makes that filming a whole hell of a lot easier. And secondly all, if that's a word, congratulations on the One NZ, mate. You must be stoked to be carrying that round this year.
Yeah, mate, no, it's been a dream come true, to be honest. I've been racing for 10 years and obviously been mentored by the best in the business, in my opinion, Hig. So, I was really pleased to finally do the combination some justice.
Now, tell me, when you knew you won the New Zealand title, I mean, you're sitting in your car, what was your reaction?
Numb at the beginning, because I didn't believe it. It's, you know, something you've chased for so long, and I guess I'd sort of become used to feeling a bit disappointed and dealing with the highs and lows of the sports, particularly at the New Zealand's, and to finally win it. It's obviously a feeling I've never experienced before, so just tried to take it all in.
Now, is it one of those addictive feelings that you want to get every time you go race your Superstock now?
No, it was more a feeling of complacency afterwards. You know, it's something you've chased for so long, and we've got a family on the way, and we've been grafting away for a wee while now. So, yeah, I'm pretty happy with what we've achieved now, and we're just going to go and enjoy our Speedway.
Okay, so does that mean that you've done what you needed to do now, and perhaps it's maybe to take a couple of steps back?
Yeah, certainly we're not going to try as hard as we have. I mean, obviously we're going to still go out and try and win, but yeah, we're just going to concentrate more on enjoying the sport and, you know, just getting around as many tracks as we can with the 1NZ and just try and do the numbers some justice.
Now tell me, I know you do a lot of dedication to the sport, especially racing the Superstock and the North Island, stuff like that. I mean, what does it take? I mean, is it understanding family is obviously one of those things, but a personal toll, is there a lot that you're having to go up and down the country to race and get race with the best?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, these things soak up easy 20 hours a week in maintenance and preparation. a very understanding wife. I mean, I don't think I've been home for how many weekends. Last weekend was my first weekend at home since Christmas, and we're about due to have a baby, so she's very understanding. Obviously a hugely supportive family. Mum and Dad pump the money in and all our sponsors, so we've got a huge backing to make our campaigns possible.
Okay, well, obviously we're here tonight for the South Island title. The car, we've already had heat number one. How's it going? I mean, you're up there in the top, what, five or so, so you must be pretty happy with the way it was it?
Yeah, we started off grid 24 and snuck through up to fifth, so we're pretty happy with that. We're just got to try and get another couple of clean heats in and see how the points stack up at the end of it.
Now, you've had a couple of bad runs with the car too, I'm led to believe, a couple of things letting go, gearboxes and a wee bit of a fire at Palmerston North Speedway. No problems with the car tonight?
No, not at all. A wee bit of a fire, that's an understatement if ever I heard one. But yeah, no, like I say, that comes back to the huge support from our family and crew and sponsors, and even other drivers in Palmy. Damien all supplied us a seat, and Sean Pearson organised all the steel we needed. And I mean, that just shows you how awesome these guys are in the sport. Doesn't matter if you're the opposition team, they do anything to help you to get you back out there, and that's what it's all about.
And the other amazing thing I find with this particular class as well is that they'll go out and wreck you, but as soon as they've wrecked you, they'll give you a hand to put you back together again.
Yeah, no, that's exactly the case, especially in teams racing. I mean, the people that are teams racing have generally got a bit of experience, and to be fair, the top guys in the country, so everyone understands how it all works, and everyone's, you know, really good.
Okay, you're carrying the one engine on the car now. What's the plan? Are you going to be doing a couple of South Island tricks and get around the countryside to show it off?
Yeah, no, we certainly are. I mean, we've already done the 240s in Rotorua, which was a bit of a, it wasn't a very good meeting, to be honest, one to forget. We had a few breakdowns and things, and we went down to Christchurch for the final round of the South Island series, which we were lucky enough to win. So, you know, we're just going to keep trying our hardest and try and do that number some justice.
Okay, so back to the South Island title again. Well, obviously, you're starting off the front in this one. Just play it cool and get in the lead and just see what happens from there, is it?
Yeah, I think we're off grid 11 or 7. I'm actually not too sure which one it is, so we'll just try and toot through and get a few more spots. It's all about passing cars and, like I say, tally the points up and see how it looks.
Defending champion Malcolm Nartai is not looking too bad. Got a bit of a plan for him if he gets too close?
No, he's a South Island car, so we'll just let him run his race. He's another good guy that travels a lot, so it's getting to the point where it doesn't matter what track code's on the car. It's more about the person, and it's actually just a huge big group, so I think you'll find as these things progress, people don't get too stressed about the letter on the car. It's more the person and how much effort they put in, to be honest.
Okay, so only thing left really to do is you get an opportunity to thank all those sponsors that look after you, mate. Who are they?
We've got ITM, Bluebridge, Total Lubricants, Heslot Motor Group, Jeff Hume from Summit, and Charlie Harwood Builders, obviously, the old man, High Reach, and yeah, there's heaps of others, too many to list, but without them we couldn't do it.
Okay, folks, here we go, 29C, Murray Gregor, the South Island title here. Now, Murray, we haven't seen you around the traps for a long time. This car's been a long time in the making, but apparently a bit of an illness to get over first, was it?
A bit of what?
An illness.
Oh, you just basically had a hernia there, basically, just before Christmas.
And so how are you going? Like, the car's going all right, you're going okay?
Yeah, the car's good, it's just me, I suppose. It's like, it's all just time, seat time.
Okay, so what sort of motor and what sort of package is obviously Top Gear chassis now, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Top Gear chassis, running a Toyota, but you basically need four good wheels to carry on out there.
Yeah, we just had race number one and you only had three to complete the race on. Pretty hard to do that, is it? What happened?
Yeah, especially in the first corner or second corner, all the cars basically go on the same corner at the same time and crash bang, and I come out with a flat tyre.
Well, it's not so bad, is it? But at the end of the day, it could be a lot worse. A couple of guys there, a lot of damage. I think 48 Brett Nichols, he's repairing his car because his whole wheel come off.
Yeah, a bit of bad luck for Brent. I think he's done a couple of injuries this year as well. And well, especially after last year, I think he won the South Island title in Christchurch last year.
Yeah, that's a bit of a shame. But obviously, everything's going okay. Got good sponsors on the side of the car?
Oh, yeah, it's just a hobby at the end of the day. So, yeah, I basically probably fork out most of it, but yeah.
Okay, so you travel up from Invercargill as well?
Yeah, from the deep south. Brought the nice weather up with me.
Absolutely. Well, best of luck for the remaining two heats, Murray.
Thanks, Chase.
Okay, folks, here we are, South Island Superstock title. And, of course, Damien Alley here in the 8 car. Now, Damien, we've seen you doing a lot of Superstock racing over the last, you know, especially last season or so. Is it starting to pay off that seat time?
I tell you what, it's seat time, it's also wallet time, you know. Unfortunately, to get it right, you've got to pay the money. So we are getting there. It's one of those sports, you've got to love it to enjoy it, and if you don't enjoy it, don't do it. So we're still here.
Well, the amazing thing is this car, this whole package looks absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's a great looking bus there, a great looking car. Do you do all your own sign writing?
Yeah, we do. We do all our own sign writing in-house, so it makes it a lot easier, yeah.
Okay, you've had heat number one now. How's the car? How yourself?
Belt slipped and snapped in the first practice, so we're not bad. Second one, fuel pump let go, so let's just hope we got it for the second one.
Alrighty, so starting off where in the next two heats?
Haven't checked yet, but I'll have a look.
I don't think it's going to be a very good start, eh?
Yeah, good field cars though, so hey, let's go and have fun.
And I suppose it's all good experience for you though, isn't it?
Yeah, laps and hot laps is fun, and seat times is experience.
Okay, heat number two, your grid start. Of grid number one, it is the 8 car of Damien Alley. Grid two is the 84 of Anthony McKenzie. Grid three is the 5 car of Jason Fletcher. Grid four is the 27 car of Peter Fields. Grid five is the 3NZ of Graham Barr. Grid six is the 7 car of Neil Frew. Of grid number seven, it is the 48 car of Brett Nichols. Of grid number eight, it is the 23 car of Jacob Brownlee. Grid nine is the 10 car of Alex Bright. Grid 10 is the 93 car of Sonny Hammond. Of grid 11, it is the 1NZ of Shane Harwood. Grid 12 is the 34 car of Rebecca Barr. Grid 13 is the 4 car of Kevin Clive. Grid 14 is the 92 car of Jason McConnell. Grid 15 is the 74 car of Ian Clayworth. Grid 16 is the 24 car of Luke Ewing. Grid 17 is the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai. Grid 18 is the 99C car of Dennis Andresian. Grid 19 is the 46 car of Blair Cunningham. Grid 20 is the 36 car of Jake Baker. Of grid 21, it is the 95 car of Alex Hill. Of grid 22, it is the 186 car of Jared Gray, who will not be out for this one. Of grid 23, it is the 99 car of Trevor Lynham. Of grid 24, it's the 9 car of Jamie Hamilton. Of grid 25, it is the 29 car of Murray Gregg. 26 is the 6 car of Ben Taylor. And grid 27 is the 56 car of Kerry Pradurski. He's ready. The car's getting off. We are ready here for heat number two of the Fuchs Lubricant South Island Superstock Champs, and we are racing. And as they go in the shop corner now, it is the 8 car now of Damien Alley who leads it, but it is the 84 of Anthony McKenzie who gets out of there the best. Now Damien Alley down the inside, there's a bit of who's who now as Graham Barr, the 3NZ, he's got locked up on the 8 car of Alley. They're on the infield, probably going to take out half the field as well. So the 3NZ of Barr and the 8 of Damien Alley there off. Are off at the moment. The 1NZ car now, Shane Harwood down the inside of the 84 of Anthony McKenzie. He can't get the job done now, but will still be looking to do it there on shop corner. Alex Bright in third position now. So Barr and Alley back down the field. There is the 48 car hitting more trouble, and that's the Brett Nichols car, and also the 36 car of Jake Baker there. It is still though, Shane Harwood now in the lead as the 48 car of Brett Nichols pulls off. Jack Baker there just exiting Bigsies Hill now. Looks like he's got a bit of a mechanical problem or just slowing down for the lead cars. But it is the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood who leads it out from Anthony McKenzie. Then we go back to the 10 car of Alex Bright, then the 7 of Neil Frew, who's in fourth, and then the 23 car of Jacob Brownlee's. That's your top five at the moment. Jamie Hamilton's on the charge, he's in sixth position now. He started off grid 24. The 9 car from Woodford Glen Speedway's on the charge as the 56 car of Kerry Pradurski's hitting more trouble. But it is still the 1NZ, Shane Harwood, who leads it now from Anthony McKenzie. There's a tangle on Bigsies Hill. It's the 7 car of Root and the 9 car of Hamilton. So Hamilton has lost a bit of his work now with the 19 car of Nartai's up there. The 29 looks like he's gone to the infield up front. We've got a red flag here. And it is for that 7 car of Neil Frew. Must have put the thumbs down. They do a very simple system here. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Thumbs down means you want to come off. Thumbs up means you want to stay on. But to be honest, Neil Frew, it's immediately thumbs down when you're midway through Bigsies Hill. So yep, starter's hands now. So the leader is the 1NZ, Shane Harwood. 7 of 15 gone, race fans. 8 to go, same point as the yellows last time, reds last time as we are racing. And the 5 car of Fletcher struggling to start. So that's the only problem here from the restarts. The 99 of Lynham hits the wall now. And the 95 N car of Alex Hill goes to the infield, but it is still the one in debt of Shane Harwood who leads it now. In second place is the 84 car of Anthony McKenzie. 99 Lynham has parked it up there on shop corner. Third position now in still. It is now Ben Taylor as the 74 car of Clayworth goes to the infield. So Nelson pretty much almost occupying the infield now as Jamie Hamilton makes the pass there on Alex Bright, but he's still a lap down. Graham Barr's passing me in the control tower, but Murray Gregg's got a few problems here. The front wheels are wobbling like anything you wouldn't imagine. And there's a bit of a gap here between, sorry, not a gap, a bit of a pile up here between the 92 car of Jason McConnell and it looks like the 27 of Peter Fields. 10 laps gone and we're on red light again. And it will be for the 27 of Peter Fields, the 92 car of Jason McConnell, and it looks like the 36 car of Jake Baker there is also involved. As the lights are out and the green goes down, we are icing here, and it is Shane Harwood who leads it. 5 laps gone, 10 out of 15 gone, now it's 11. Shane Harwood's in the front now, then we go back to the 84 of Anthony McKenzie, then the 6 of Ben Taylor, the 10 of Alex Bright, and then the 19 of Malcolm Nartai. So heat one winner, Malcolm Nartai's in fifth position when he started off grid number 17 now. So Nartai's trucking dirt here at Frosty's towing Nelson Speedway. As there's Blindham still circling around the wall there on shop corner now. But the 1NZ car untouched at the moment of Shane Harwood, 2 laps to go now. Anthony McKenzie still in second place there as Ben Taylor third, Alex Bright fourth. Malcolm Nartai's the 4 car of Kevin Kleiss at the wall. Sideways now, so cars will have to avoid him. He'll have to turn that round real quickly as he hits the 46 car of Blair Cunningham. White flag now for Shane Harwood in the 1NZ car. As they go down the back straight now, Clive's rejoined the race after that spin there, but it will, should be the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood who will take heat number 2 of the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstock Championships here. Second will be the 84 car of Anthony McKenzie. Third will be the 10 car of Alex Bright. Fourth will be the 19 of Malcolm Nartai. Fifth will be the 23 car of Jacob Brownlee. Sixth will be the 6 car of Ben Taylor. Seventh will be the 34 of Rebecca Barr. Eighth will be the 46 of Blair Cunningham. Ninth will be the 99 of Dennis Andresen. And top 10 rounding out is the 56 car of Kerry Pajerski. As there's a bit of a tangle up there on Bigsy's Hill between the 4 car of Kevin Clive and the 36 of Jake Baker. And it is all on here as we go into heat number 3 later on in the evening.
Okay, folks, here we go. Heat number 2 of the South Island Superstock title, and the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood goes across the line in first spot. Shane, she looks like she's pretty hard work out there. Bit of a sweat brewing up.
Yeah, no, the gravy mill's working overtime at the moment. We did go good. We got a good start and snuck past and a couple of laps in and had Ben running tail gun for us. So, no, it went pretty well, to be honest.
Good to have a Nelson one behind you, a couple of Nelson guys behind you looking after your butt, basically.
Yeah, no, it was really good. Towards the end, we're catching up to some lap traffic and so we just got out of the gas a wee bit. Both Ant and I and just stayed away, tried to gap ourselves from any of that lap traffic and tried to run it clean.
Okay, must be the only real threat for you at the moment. So Malcolm Nartai, you got a bit of an answer for him?
No, he can just run. He can go for it. Like I said before, it doesn't matter what track code's on the car. We all travel together in that, so may the best man win.
And I suppose the only thing to really do is make sure it doesn't go to the North Island.
I think that's pretty well covered with 23 Nelson cars and the rest North Island. I can't see that being too much of an issue, to be honest.
Okay, track, liking it? Everybody's raving about how great it is out there.
Yeah, the track guys do a fantastic job. You know, there's hours and hours going to that. The crowd aren't out here seeing it. We don't see it, but obviously Brendan Higgins does the track, which is obviously a favourite bloke of mine. So, I appreciate the hours they put into it and all the volunteers for that matter.
Absolutely. Tell us, where do you start off in the last race?
I'm off grid 11, so it might be 7 actually, either or. So, yeah, we just got to try and keep our tail clean and run for it.
What you think you do with your four-wheel drive. What you actually do with your four-wheel drive.
No matter what you do with your four-wheel drive, we've got the right tyre for you. So come on down to Mag & Turbo.
At Hamner Holiday Homes, they pride themselves on offering accommodation solutions to suit almost any budget. Only a short 95 minutes from Christchurch, tucked away beneath the mountains, is Hamner Springs, a nature's wonderland. Whether you're looking for a home the whole family can enjoy, have a barbecue and let the children play free, or a quiet hideaway for two in a peaceful retreat, from the larger house to the small, Hamner Holiday Homes offer it all. HamnerHolidayHomes.com. Book now.
It's tyre sale time at Mag and Turbo, and we've got 14-inch Nexon tyres from $89, 15s from $99, and 7-inch high-performance tyres from only $129. 15 stores nationwide, but only at Mag and Turbo.
Hi, I'm Scott Williamson, and welcome to X Factor Cars. Family-owned and operated from two locations, Invercargill and Cromwell. Specialising in everything V8 from Holden Ford, HSV, FPV, and with Southland's biggest selection of American muscle, we've got most bases covered. You only live once, but if you do it right, once is enough. Get the X Factor.
As we are racing for the last heat of the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstock Championship here at Frosty's Towing Nelson Speedway. And it is carnage from the get-go, and Dennis Adresian's been spun around. There's a bit of a carnage there. It looks like it's the 34 car of Rebecca Barr who's been spun up there. That's the 1NZ car, Shane Harwood, who leads it, tied on points there. Nartai's getting pushed around there by the 46 in tank there, so it looks like a bit of Nelson versus Christchurch here for the last race of the Fuchs Lubricants South Island Superstock Championships. As it is, the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood who leads it there from the 9 car of Jamie Hamilton. Then we go back to the 99 of Trevor Lynham there, and then the 6 car of Ben Taylor. In fifth position there is the 10 car of Alex Bright. That's your top 5 at the moment. Nartai, he's all the way back in 9th now. All he has to do, here comes a bit of teamwork there, so it looks like Jamie Hamilton in the 9 car, looks like he's going to try help out the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai, as Hamilton gives Harwood a bit of push now. Potentially I might crash into him lower around Pixie's Hill, but doesn't do so. So it looks like Hamilton, he's not going to touch the 1NZ car of Harwood, who's in second place now. As the, it looks to be, not too sure what the blue car around the outside there. But anyway, the Murray Greig 29, he's spun around the infield. It looks like the 1NZ car, Shane Harwood, he's passed Hamilton, but then Hamilton gets him right back now. Nartai's making his charge through the traffic now. He's now up into eighth position now, with 10 laps to go now in the South Island Superstock Championships. Hamilton still leads it though, followed by Harwood. Then we go back to the 99 of Lynham. Then the 10 car of Bright, Taylor. Then the 23 car of Brownlee, the 36 of Baker, Nartai in 8th position still. So maybe some Christchurch guys, they might want to start trying to help out the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai, the defending champ, as the 36 car of Jack Jake Baker goes around now. Nartai misses him just. As we go back up to the race leader now, Jamie Hamilton still leads it now. Baker still spun around Bixie's Hill now. Just avoids the nine car of Jamie Hamilton, the 1NZ car. Shane Harwood leads it though. He's in second place now. Nartai, he's trying to do as much as he can, trying to get that right rear right down into the dirt, trying to get as much grip out of it and stagger out of it as he can. The nine car Hamilton, no one's helping the 19 car. So maybe the Christchurch guys aren't really focused about helping the 19 car of Malcolm Nartai win this. Or are they? Are they just playing dumb for the final five laps? Hamilton's about to hit it as the 92 car of Jason McConnell. It goes into the infield now. The 9 car of Jamie Hamilton still leads it. Then we go back to the 1NZ of Shane Harwood as the 5 car. Jason Fletcher goes to the infield. Five laps to go now. The 9 car, he's gone from the 1NZ now. Jamie Hamilton, he's in a mind of his own now. And the 1NZ car getting slowed down there by the 99 car. So the 99 car of Dennis Andresia might want to try help out the 19 car, but he can't do so. Nartai might want to go higher around Bixie's Hill now. He's got to make it clear. Gabby uses his front gun and bumps out of the way now. So Nartai trying to make as much room as he can between him, well, less room as he can between him and the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood. 12 laps gone out of 15. 3 laps to go now for Harwood. Hamilton still leads it though. Next lap will be white flag for him now. So it goes Hamilton, Harwood, Lynham, Bright, Nartai. Nartai now in fifth position now. The man from Cantabland is in fifth position. He's making his move now. Next he's got to pass the 99 car of Trevor Lynham, but the 1NZ is in second place. It's white flag now. All he's got to do is stay there, and he surely should be the new Fuchs Lubricant South Island Superstock Championship. As Hamilton, he will take the checker flag for this one, but it doesn't matter for Jamie Hamilton as Shane Harwood takes out second position in what should be his South Island Championships. He should be unconfirmed results as of yet though, but it should be the 1NZ car of Shane Harwood on 77 points who might take out the Fuchs Lubricant South Island Superstock Championships. And third we go back to Alex Bright, fourth Lynham, fifth Nartai, sixth Brownlee, seventh Cunningham, eighth Taylor, ninth McKenzie, and 10th Damien Alley.
Okay, folks, here we are, the South Island Superstock title, and third overall is this chap here, the 10 of Alex Bright. Now, Alex, been playing it pretty quiet all night, just stayed out of trouble and just did what you need to do to achieve there.
Yeah, no, definitely was quite action-packed, really, with 27 cars on the small Nelson track. I mean, it was all about just staying out of trouble and keeping your nose clean and finishing races.
And do you think you've done that quite well, but did you come into too much grief over the three heats?
Yeah, and the last one we had a fair bit of attention from a couple of Christchurch cars. But apart from that, we seem to be pretty clean, really.
Biggest result of the season so far, is it?
Yep, no, it's a good one.
And you'll be pretty pleased, obviously, with that result. Good amount of people to help you out. Who are they?
Yeah, we got Mum, Dad, all the crew, Kyle, Annalise, Cameron, Conrad, and got all the sponsors. We've got MTF, Vehicle Finance, we've got D2C, got Jack's Tyres, Total Sheet Metals, and Midwest Motors.
Okay, folks, here we go. Second overall for the South Island title, brought to us by Fuchs. It is, of course, the man himself, 19, Malcolm Nartai. Not first, Mal, but bloody good to achieve that second spot. You must still be pretty happy with that result.
Yeah, well, it just goes to show, you know, you coming second to Shane Harwood, he's the best in the country. I don't mind coming second to Shane any day of the world.
And, of course, a bit of a late surge from you as well. Everybody's telling me how great it was towards the end of the race there. Car starting to come on good for you, was it?
Yeah, we set it up for the second half of the race. I got caught up behind a few of the slower markers there for a bit, but we were starting to get through that traffic pretty quick. I don't know if we would have caught Shane unless someone held him, but hey, we held our second, and that's I'm happy with that result.
Absolutely, and I suppose not a bad way heading into the Battle of the Stocks, but showing a bit of form as well.
Yeah, it's about time, isn't it?
For this season it is, Mel, but you haven't really done many, have you?
Yeah, no, I haven't done a lot, and we haven't really done much with the car either, so we've been to see Murray, and he's sorted the car out and given me a bit of a tune-up, and we're back into it.
Absolutely, and so it will be a full program next season, will it?
Full program, new car coming next season, brand new Murray Gorge on the way. There's nothing wrong with this car, but I sort of fought them on my last 5 years, so I might as well make it my last new one, and we'll play around for the saloon for a bit, and... I'll get into that later on, but I'm not quite old enough for those saloon things yet.
Okay, good sponsor on the car too, Mel. Who looks after you, bud?
I'm still into his specialist. He keeps the engine going, him and Graham Morrison. And obviously my own company, Suck It Up in Christchurch. We're working for the rebuild, Elite Wheels. Shit, we've got Safer Toolboxes, Kaikanui Tavern, Auto Scan Solutions. Oh, I got to think of them all. You put me on the spot, but if I've missed any of them, the print companies that sponsor us, and just all the people that help us out for the year,
Now, you must have a good Facebook page or a website at least where people can go and see these good sponsors, eh?
Yeah, with a great face like this, you've got to have a good Facebook page. We have a good Facebook page. We try and update it as much as we can. And there's a bit of guff on there. Sponsors are on there. Some of the stuff we get up to is on it. So, yeah.
How do they find it?
Just 19C Superstock's always a good start, and we're not far from there.
Okay, well, congratulations on second spot, Mel.
Yeah, cheers, Jace.
And Shane, just continuing on from a fantastic season so far. What does it mean to you to win the South Island title?
No, it's awesome to win the South Island title. We've had it before, so it's 6 years ago or so. And it's awesome to put it together tonight and carry on our winning streak at the moment. It's unreal. So real happy with the crew and how the guys are prepping the car. It's going really good. And just stoked that all the guys travelled down from the North Island and all the boys up from Christchurch. It was a massive meeting, so that was real cool.
And that must have been one of the hardest South Island titles that's ever been done. I mean, there's 27 cars here that were vying for the same spot you were, and of course, even harder for you, but played it cool. Obviously, car setup was good, track was good, everything played into your hands?
Yeah, no, it went really well, and it was nice, clean racing, and it was awesome to have 26 cars out there. Like, that's an unreal number for the South Island champs. So yeah, like I say, it's awesome that the four North Islanders come down and had huge support from Christchurch to come up, made it a great meeting.
Absolutely, good warm up for the Battle of the Stocks coming up.
Yeah, certainly, we're off to Teams Nationals in Auckland first, and then giving the car to one of our main sponsors for the following weekend.
Do you prefer? Do you prefer the teams racing or the individual stuff?
Well, to be honest, we've sort of achieved everything we set out to achieve. So like I said earlier, we're just sort of going to enjoy our Speedway with the team. They're great guys, love being a part of the team. So we're going to race hard until such time as we decide we need to step aside.
Okay, good sponsors on the car. Who are they?
ITM, Bluebridge, Heslop Motor Group, Jeff Hume from Summit, Ash Bradley Auto Refinishes, Total Oils. Yeah, there's a number of them. They're awesome, man. We couldn't do it without them.
Congratulations, mate, on the South Island and the 1NZ.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Superstocks, and we thank Fuchs for their sponsorship tonight. They've done us proud. These drivers have done us proud. It's probably the biggest and best New Zealand South Island Superstock title. Sorry, guys, I'm getting a bit tired. That we've seen in a very, very long time, and these guys have done both the spectators and the supporters proud. And we take our hats off to the crews for keeping these cars going over this race evening. As we line them back up, huge field of Superstocks, and Dressen, Baker, and Jason Fletcher off the front row. Here we go back to Ants McKenzie. Graham Barr, see if he can pick up a race win on behalf of the North Islanders as they fire through down the front straight. And as they head through, not sure, 15 laps for this one. And out in front of this, Jason Fletcher from Ants McKenzie. A couple of cars heading towards the wall. Jared Gray, one of the cars that's slow to take off. Out in front, Jason Fletcher, the king killer for the Canterbury Glen Eagles over the Palmerston North Panthers. Just a couple of weeks ago, Jake Baker went behind him. from Palmerston North. Then we go back to the Jamie Hamilton machine. Graham Barr, Malcolm Nardwuar making a great start through on this particular race. Then we go back to Jacob Brownlee's. Kerry Bajewski, Jared Gray just spinning up one of the back markers there. Not too sure who that was. And it looks like Dennis Andresen having a bit of a fight with Luke Ewing. And in behind them, Ants McKenzie and Murray Gregg and Blair Cunningham down the back of the pack. So just having a look through here. But it is Jason Fletcher having a holiday home, making a great fist of this race. Of course, they've got the home living extra house up here that they live in and frequent while they're staying up here. And they're looking forward, hopefully, to being back here at Easter time as well. As Blem Cunningham pays the tank duties, maybe getting in a bit of blocking practice before he heads to Auckland. Luke Ewing in the 24 car having a few issues, but Blair doing his Moseley best, what he does best, one of the best blockers in the business, and he just lets rip and tries to stop some of these fast cars. Here comes Graham Barr on the back of the Cunningham tank. He takes off in pursuit of Jason Fletcher as he gets a big hit from Jamie Hamilton. Jamie Hamilton, a big dive on Graham Barr, huge run in Bixie's Hill, and we knew Jamie Hamilton, he's not too uncommon for him to get that front bumper going, and the recipient of that was Graham Barr. Graham Barr heads to the infield, so that's the end of him. Now he's firing back up again, and it is Jamie Hamilton that's stalled up there in Bixie's Hill. So we did see the big hit come in for the night, and it was Jamie Hamilton trying to have a fly on the 3NZ of Graham Barr. As we look through, Jason Fletcher still leading Malcolm Nartoy up into second spot, just looking for Shane Harwood. He's in sixth spot at the moment, coming through traffic. And Blair Cunningham just playing block mode at the moment, just shooting round, tries to pick up Malcolm Nardwuar and does so. Malcolm getting spun up by Blair Cunningham, the tank commander doing the best, and no doubt Malcolm Nardwuar will send it amongst Blair Cunningham. That battle might presume at the Battle of the Stocks in just a few weeks' time, as we see Shane Harwood heading infield. His day is done as Jamie Hamilton still parked up. Jared Gray coming through here with Trevor Lynham as they battle each other. Jamie Nelly in with Ants McKenzie. Then we go back to Dennis Andresen right off the back, and Graham Barr through there as well. But out in front it is Jason Fletcher. Can he pick up a second race win in as many weeks? Going great guns at the moment. The Hamden Holiday Homes, it'll be a great way to go home. He probably won't take off his race uniform again tonight to have a race in the feature of the South Island title as we go through lap 9 onto lap 10. So 5 laps to go as the rest of the cars try and sort themselves out. And it is Jake Baker, 36, that's in second spot, although Jacob Brownlee's has just passed him. Blair Cunningham just trying to block the tank, so the two tanks having a bit of a battle. Malcolm Nardwuar trying to head back up through the field, and he'll be chasing down that Blair Cunningham tank, no doubt, as Jacob Brownlee's having a first crack at Blair Cunningham. But out in front, it is still Jason Fletcher with a couple to go as we see Ants McKenzie taking off the track. Malcolm Nardwuar putting Jake Baker up to the wall out of turn two. So plenty of excitement happening through here. Jamie Hamilton still parked down on Bixie's Hill. And it looks like Malcolm Nardwuar has broken something. It could be a flat tyre. Yeah, flat right front tyre for Malcolm Nardwuar. So that'll be his dash done. But at the moment, Jason Fletcher having a holiday home. Three to go. Will he pick up another race win? We're waiting to see. He's got an Elster car in front of him. Chasing him down is Jacob Brownlee's and Jake Baker. Still heading through there. Kerry Bajewski up in the podium spots at the moment. As we see through two alignment, not too far away. Malcolm Nardwuar going backwards. Graham Barr back up to sixth spot after that big hit, courtesy of Jamie Hamilton. So still plenty of action going. As we go 13, 14, white flag out for Jason Fletcher. Mr. Hamner Holiday Homes on the white flag. Malcolm Nardwuar just circulating. Here comes Jason Fletcher, just keeping out of trouble. Blair Cunningham on the back of Jason Fletcher. Will he catch him? No, he won't. Jason Fletcher might pick up his second race win. He's just going to go down the inside and will win by a couple of car lengths from Kerry Bajewski. Jacob Brownlee picks up third spot. Jake Baker from Palmerston North Racing 36 and picks up fourth spot from Trevor Lynham. Graham Barr, Dennis Andresen, Damien Alley, Luke Ewing, Blair Cunningham, lap down, Malcolm Nartoy, Jared Gray, Ants McKenzie, Shane Harwood parked up, Jamie Hamilton parked up, and Murray Gregg parked up on the infield. So there we go. Jason Fletcher picks up his second race win, and no doubt Karen will be absolutely a stack up there down there by turn number 3. The Hamden Holiday Homes sponsored machine, proud sponsor of the South Island Superstock Series, picks up a race win, and he'll be absolutely wrapped with that. Finding the podium, might have to grow a beard by Huggies.
Okay, folks, here we go. The winner of the feature race here for the South Island Superstocks. Not the one you wanted to win, but hey, still at the end of the day, a win.
A win is a win, mate, and it's my first win here and first win under normal individuals racing, so I'll take that one. But once again, I go across the line and think, did I win that or not? Came back to the checker flag, he gave it to me, I thought he was taking the piss, so I was a bit surprised. I thought Graham Barr and old Cunningham had got inside me, and I didn't even see the flag. That's why I spun Cunningham up after the flag and took him into the wall, but I honestly thought he'd got me. But yeah, apparently I need to practice watching the flagman a little bit more.
Absolutely, but of course, I mean, you must have been pretty well. Everything was sort of focused on getting that car across the line. A couple of spots there looked like the car was sort of might have gone off a wee bit. Yeah. Was the handling starting to sort of scrub a wee bit there?
Yeah, it was. We actually tightened it up a bit because the beginning of the race, as I was finding, I was actually not quite right and having to make up places halfway through the race. So in this case, we tightened it up a little bit and she was good. But then towards the end of the race, I started to push a fair bit and I was just lucky. Buggered gearbox again. This time it's hassled me the whole night. And fortunately, she managed to hold together, no red lights or anything like that, so I was lucky.
Absolutely. And of course, you know, there's this calibre of car that's racing in that race as well. I mean, it was pretty much some of the best of the best. Well, it was the best of the best in New Zealand that were racing in that last race, so you must have been absolutely stoked about it.
Oh, yes and no. I think they were all having a bit of a party behind me. I didn't see much once I got out, leapt out in front. I just kept in front. I actually knew the car was on song as far as speed went, because in that, I think it was the second heat, we had the fastest lap there, and I know old 1NZ was sitting in the pocket and not really pushing his car, but I was pleased to be able to get, you know, a really good fast time. So the car's got the boogie, it's just need the driver needs to work out how to pick the boogie properly.
I'd just let you know, Paderewski was about two car lengths behind you at the start-finish line, so You nearly just about cooked your goose, but you did enough.
Did enough, and that's good. That's all you got to do is just get across the line and win, and I'm really happy about that.
Absolutely. Who's the good sponsors on the car there? Who are they?
We got R&G Homes. They look after us really well. Old Jason Reed, thanks very much. Hamden Holiday Homes. Have to mention also R.E. Sinclair's, who do a dono work. And, of course, HBE, Gavin Hill there, who does a great job on the motor. So much appreciated. And, Gav, you don't have to worry, mate. We found out the overheating problem. Chucked the radiator out, chucked a new one in, and she's as good as gold.
Well, he'll be pleased about that. Congratulations on the heat win.
Thank you. We'll